Hey guys, and welcome back. So in the last lecture, we installed Unity and Vuforia. In this lecture, what we're going to do is we're going to create our first augmented reality app. So the first app will consist of generating a simple marker and then superimposing a cube on top of it. Okay, so let's get started. First, open up Unity. Go ahead and create a new project, and let's call it AR project number one. Leave all the other settings as is and create project. Just wait for Unity to load up. So this is the Unity editor for those who aren't very familiar with Unity. So I'm not going to go into all the details of how it works or how to use it, because I assume that you're a bit familiar with Unity. Okay, so first of all, what we do is we're going to import our Vuforia Unity package. In the last lecture, we already imported it, but if you don't know how to import it, or if you still haven't imported it, all you have to do is just drag and drop and it'll import automatically. Leave everything as is and import. Make sure you're running the latest version of Unity and Vuforia. This is to avoid any errors that may occur. Okay, so once we've imported Vuforia, click on Assets, Vuforia, Prefabs, and then drag and drop our AR camera. And go ahead and delete the main camera. Let's save our project. Let's save scene as. I'm going to call it AR scene 1. So under inspector, click on AR camera. And first thing we need to do is copy and paste our app license key from the Vuforia website. So to do that, let's go over to our browser. And then head over to developer.vuforia.com. First of all, what you need to do is to log on to your Vuforia account. So I've already logged in. And then once you've logged in, go over to develop. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add a license key. Because we're only developing a simple app, we can click development. We're going to call this app marker 1. And because we're developing, there's no charge for this license key. Go ahead and click next. So for this license key, we have the develop package, which is no charge, which allows us 100 Rico usage per month, 1,000 cloud targets per month, and Vuforia templates, which is one active. View marks is 100. Click the checkbox over here and click continue or confirm. So once that's done, click on App Marker 1. And over here, we present it with our license key. So what you do, you copy and copy it into your Unity editor. And the only other thing that we need to set is our world center mode. And this, we're going to specify device tracking. Just make sure you save a project or scene. Now what we do is we have to import our image target. So go back to the Vuforia website and go to Target Manager. Click on Add Database. And let's create a name for our database. So the image type that I'm going to put in is an image magazine cover of Iron Man. So that's what I'm going to name my database. The type will be device and click Create. So you can use any image as a marker. Magazine covers are very good for tracking, so let's look for our target image. So you can use any image as an image marker. I'm going to use this Iron Man cover as my marker. So click on your database, click Add Target, and we're going to just have a single image. At the later stage, we're going to have multiple targets. But for now, let's focus on a single image. We're going to go to Browse and click on our Iron Man image. Both you can specify at around 5. So according to this, we enter the width of your target in the scene. So the size of the target should be on the same scale as your augmented reality virtual content. So it says that Vuforia uses meters as a default unit of scale, and the target height will be calculated upon the upload of your image. So then you can go ahead and add your image. Just give it some time to upload. And then we can download our database, which will be used in the Unity editor. I'm going to save the file. To import our image target, drag and drop our marker into Unity. We can just click import, and it will import our target into Unity. So what you're going to do is to click on AR camera. Under database, click on load Iron Man database and click activate. Under assets, Vuforia, prefabs, click on image target and drag it into the scene. Make sure image target is a child of the AR camera. Under database, click Iron Man and that should be set. Okay, so now that we've imported our image target, we now need to add a cube on top of our image. So what we do is we go to 3D object, cube, and a cube will be overlaid onto our image. Now this looks a bit big, so let's size it down just a little bit. That looks about right. So what you can do now is you can add a material to easily discern our cube. Or you can add a normal image from the internet. I have another image over here which I'm going to drag into my Vuforia materials folder. And I want to put this on top of my cube. All you have to do is just drag and drop your image and it will appear on your cube. Make sure your cube is a child of image target. Now let's see if our image works. Okay, let's see if this works. Okay, cool. So we can see our block and it's appearing on our marker. It looks quite robust and is working really well. Now, what you can do to make this look a bit cooler is you can make this a little bit bigger. Let's pull our cube a little bit higher to make it look like it's floating. Click play. And there we have our cube working really well. It also looks like it's floating on our image. Okay, and there you have it. You see our cube is floating on our marker. You can use a paper version of this instead of a digital version, which would work better. Mainly because you can avoid glare from surrounding lights. You can see it looks very cool, and just wait till we get into the nitty-gritty of this course. Things will get much more exciting. Okay, so thank you for watching, and I'll see you next video.